Now, even though Microsoft's Windows Phone 8 operating system may not be the best one out there when it comes to sales, there is no denial that a lot of us at Pocket Now do love the UI and do love the whole Windows Phone ecosystem, precisely because of its minimalism, great camera quality, and lots of features that we do love. Still, there are a ton of things that we wish we saw in 2014, so I'm Jaime Rivera. This is Pocket Now, and these are the wishes that we have for Windows Phone in 2014. Number 5 is actually two things. The list was kind of big, so bear with me here. First of all, we need more players, and we mean top players. Samsung and HTC did a fabulous job in pushing Windows Phone even before Nokia came to the bandwagon, and now Nokia is everything related to Windows Phone. These companies don't really care about the platform anymore, and that is really unfortunate, as we do need a bigger push when it comes to the platform. And aside from that, we do need some better tablet integration. One of the biggest issues with Windows Phone, it's not really an issue, but it is more of a wish, is the fact that there is no benefit in owning a Windows phone and in owning a Windows tablet, and that should be the other way around. They should talk to each other. The applications that I buy for Windows Phone should work on Windows RT, or there should be a variant on Windows RT that talks to this application in a way for me not to buy two things at the same time. So I guess you understand where I'm going with the fact of better tablet integration as well. Number 4 is better commitment to legacy devices. A lot of you that bought the original Windows Phone 7 devices are not getting any more software updates. Even features like Xbox Music are not working on your phones, and this is really unfortunate. People can't really buy a phone every year, and there are a ton of people out there that are trying to buy phones at a very affordable price. And if you think about the fact that Windows Phone is more targeted to the budget audience, then you get to understand that these people are the ones that most need a platform that'll support their old legacy phones. But as it turns out, I have a beautiful Dell Venue Pro that can't get any updates anymore. I have a great HTC Titan as well that can't get any updates as well. And a lot of people said that, of course, this had to do with the platform evolving into, you know, dual core processors and everything. But whatever happened to Windows Phone 7.8? And again, it's just the fact that Microsoft is not really committing to legacy customers. And what this is doing is killing the platform going forward as people lose trust in Windows Phone. Number 3 is timely launches. Can anybody tell me where is Windows Phone 8.1? We've got KitKat in the market. We have iOS 7. Where is Windows Phone 8.1? A lot of people are asking for this. And aside from that, it's the fact that we get announcements for Windows Phone in January for them to be launched in the fall. And these are the things we can't understand why Microsoft is so sluggish and actually bringing support and growth to their own platform. They're doing a good job. Windows Phone is a great operating system, but we do have the problem that people are not going to wait 8 months for an update. People are not going to be waiting 11, 10 months for a phone. It doesn't work that way. Competition is too fierce for Microsoft to be so sluggish. Number 2 has to do with applications, but not really what you think. I do believe that Microsoft and its partners have done a fabulous job in getting the applications that we need on the platform, but then there is another problem. For example, if you're looking for Instagram, you will find Instagram, but then there are a ton of alternatives out there. And then if you look for Spotify, there is Spotify beta, but then there are a ton of alternatives out there. And if you're looking for a game and the game is not there, you get the alternatives, but that doesn't really tell you that the game is not there. So there is a lot of clutter in the App Store of a ton of applications that don't really serve any purpose. It tells you that there is no control in the App Store. There is even some weird porn in the App Store at times. And again, there just needs to be a real cleanup on the App Store, and this would actually make the App Store more prestigious. You don't really need 100,000 applications. You don't really need the volume. You needed the key applications, and they are now there. And the top number one feature that we wish would evolve for Windows Phone in 2014 is the UI. A lot of people don't really like Windows Phone, or Windows 8 for that matter. All of us at Pocket Now do, but then when I show it to a friend, then most of my friends consider it to be too stale for some reason. And yeah, they see all the flashiness of Galaxy phones, all that lighting there, and then they see all the crazy colors in iOS, and they do consider Windows Phone to be stale. And I don't feel that, I don't agree with that, but obviously I'm not part of the general population, if you get what I mean. And aside from that, there are a ton of UI elements that need to evolve. For example, the People Hub, it is completely obsolete. There are a ton of these hubs that are great, they're great concepts, and they worked really great for Windows Phone 7 3 years ago, but now they are completely obsolete compared to what you could really do with Facebook right now, for example. So there does need to be a dramatic overhaul in the UI and the services, and we're hoping that that's the reason why there is so much delay in Windows Phone 8.1. But that leads me to the question of this top 5. What would you would personally change from Windows Phone? What would you like? Because in my particular case, I would like the option to at least have a wallpaper behind the live tiles. I want the live tiles to stay. I just want there to be some sort of, you know, glass, some sort of design elements that make it look more elegant. But leave us a comment down below. What do you think? That's it for our top 5. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure you follow us on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you on the next top 5.